everybody. We are Ready, Set, Review, and today we will be reviewing Turkish Star Wars.
Also
known as The Man Who Saved the World.
Well, officially known as.
Officially known as.
The Man Who Saved the
World. Alright, this is.
I think it's World.
It's Earl.
Nick.
This is.
I'm Eric.
This is.
John.
This is.
Scott.
And I'm Kyle.
And I'm Eric.
No, I'm Eric.
You can't
hold me.
I'm
Danny. Alright, there you go. Yeah,
there was no one. There was
no one. Alright, anyways.
That's our review.
So, recently we watched the Turkish Star Wars. Now, this Star Wars was not your average Star Wars, but I will say this. It was very similar to the original Star Wars. Seeing how about 70% of the movie was literally just cut out and directly taken from Star Wars.
That is actually a really overstatement. There really isn't much from Star Wars at all.
Just, I would say like 70% of the movie.
The first like 15 minutes of clips from Star Wars.
Yeah, the first 10 minutes are a majority of Star Wars clips and archive clips from the Russian space program.
It was like 15 minutes, but they only have like 3 minutes of footage. And they just kept playing.
It was looped over and over again. So, and then they would go to like the guy inside of the spaceship, and he's like in the space pod, he's got the helmet on, he's flying through space.
Very elaborate.
The ships are going the opposite direction that he's flying.
Yeah. This
was a high quality movie, let me say that.
Now, high production value, very high production value.
can we all agree that did everybody like the movie? Like, just
it was entertaining.
You didn't have to love it, but did you at least like it? Like, you laughed?
I really liked the story, the script, the screenplay was very, very well developed.
Like, I wish we could get a copy of the script.
I would love to read the script.
Probably a book.
I would learn Turkish just to read the script.
What? Are we allowed to have spoilers?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Before we go ahead, there is going to be some spoilers, but we have exclusive rights to this public domain movie on our YouTube channel.
We actually bought it, and we bought it with the earnings we get from YouTube.
So,
which is not much.
But so, like you can click here, somewhere down here, and it'll say, hey, they'll say, hey, you, Carl, because your name's Carl, watching the video out there.
Carl.
Click this, and you can watch the Turkish Star Wars full subtitles, the only version on YouTube as of this recording.
I know, right? We rock.
Old English subtitles.
So, throwing this out here. The movie was pretty darn funny, and just because it was terrible. I mean, it was so just awful, and there were so many scenes where you're just like, I can't believe this is happening. But this is part where he rips off the monster's arm and stabs him with his arm.
Here's what I compare it to. There's always that one kid in your high school who made the excellent quality videos, which happened to be this guy in our school. But anyway, this movie is that quality.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Like, the high school...
At least mine had a story you could follow.
No, that's what we're saying.
Yeah, I mean...
This one didn't have a story.
Yeah, hold on, some of us did.
Except for the Spanish ones.
Dirty Soap?
The Spanish ones, yeah, don't... Yeah.
Can we put links to those?
I mean, people might want to watch those.
Yeah, hey, links to our YouTube channel, the YouTube channel where they're all our... No, it's not going to be different videos like this. It's just going to be the YouTube channel.
Oh, man. Well, anyway, you can watch some of the videos. Some of us are stars.
It's going to create a really audio disturbance.
I know. That's really loud. Nick, you have to cough to cover the crinkle.
Back to the subject at hand. So, the movie's not the best quality ever. It's really funny, though, and it actually, we loved it. Like, it's probably going to be
we
like...
We even made the sign.
We even made a Turkey sign.
Turkey!
Just so, whenever anybody gets confused.
Nick Hadley's quite amused.
Look how emotionless Scott is over there.
Yeah, Scott has no emotion.
Scott, what is your thoughts on the Turkish Star Wars, a.k.a. The Man Who Saved the World?
Well, since nobody mentioned it, I'd like to talk about the protagonist, the man who saved the world.
He is quite awesome.
I mean, that's much fun. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Let's talk about him, because he's awesome.
First of all... He gets beat up by these dudes, and so he goes out in the mountains, and he ties rocks to his fucking legs, and he jumps around. And he slaps the shit out of some rocks.
Yeah, he literally just like karate chopping rocks.
He kicks the rock and makes it explode on another rock.
It's pretty much the best training montage you've ever seen.
It is really
like, I thought Rocky was good, and then I watched this, and I was like, holy hell.
Imagine Chuck Norris's Turkish brother, and you got the man who saved you.
Yeah. It was pretty excellent.
He chops
a guy in half.
Directly in half.
He rips appendages off, and at one point he chest passes a mummy's head and makes it explode.
It was great.
Right in the bread basket. That's
Good pass.
I know, great pass. Good pass. I'd like to point out my creativity about making this poster on the back of a Domino's pizza box.
That is what we ate while we watched Turkish Star Wars.
Well, that was the second time that Scotty and I saw it, and we watched it twice already.
So, I mean,
and both times it was entertaining as hell. I mean, it'd be a movie I'd definitely watch again. I mean, I wouldn't watch it by myself, but if I had people over.
Yeah, it's one of those movies, if you got friends and you don't mind being a little bit funny with it. Would you guys piss off with the chips? God damn. Anyways, so. Danny, no!
Danny!
But, so it's a great movie. It's really fun. And it
blew up.
Yeah.
I have.
Fuck you guys.
So, you keep eating the chips. And like when we're going to go through
chips. They're good.
When we're going to go through with this, all right,
you can't eat just one.
I'm an addict. I'm not proud of it.
I will shake that smack and shit out of you.
All right.
Oh my Dynamite, we already tried that.
All right. Let's talk about
those.
Well,
yeah.
Why are we talking about that?
I'm
just trying to talk about the story.
John, doing the podcast.
John, yeah, go ahead, John.
Good job, John.
Well, sorry, you're hosting, but you're not hosting.
Go ahead, John. Go ahead, John.
Nope.
I wanted to talk about the story.
Eric, who are you texting?
My friend, look at your
eye. You're getting drunk. Yeah, this is like school. I'm going to put this mic down on me.
What do you guys think of the story?
What story? Pretty tough to follow. Yeah. Although, it makes sense at the end. You don't know what's going on until like the last 10 minutes.
The last 10 minutes is completely explained. But
yeah.
Basically,
in like paragraphs of dialogue.
Oh yeah, it's like dialogue. It's not even like... Oh my god.
It's like
basically,
Shakespeare stuff.
Basically the world, the earth got blown up and there's like 7 parts of the earth that are like floating around in space. And like the most powerful thing in the universe is a human brain. And like, I guess all these aliens are trying
to... Makes a shield around the...
Yeah, like people just dig their brains in the ground. Underground.
Yeah, and then it makes a shield.
Like, this is so crazy and abstract. Like, he was probably dropping acid while he was, like, trying to figure it.
But the aliens need a human brain in order to penetrate the shield to take over the fragments.
Yeah, it's like...
something, so
it
the
was
most
ridiculous.
Interesting man in Turkey has
okay,
to...
hold on. Can we talk about the part... Okay, so he gets this sword, finally, and it's like... I don't even remember how... Like, what the... Like,
some unwieldy thing.
Yeah, it was like a sword. Okay, think of a straight sword. Now I have little jagged edges on it, so if you tried to slash anything, you would just get stuck. But he slashes through everything like a boss. Now, this is what he decides to do once he has the sword. He puts it in like a smelting pot, and then he puts his fist inside there and pulls out like golden glove punching hands, and he's like...
about the brain, too.
Oh, yeah, what do you... Yeah,
it's a golden brain, a poorly painted
golden
brain.
Was that the original?
It may or may not be real.
Yeah, that's true.
It's in Turkey, so it could be.
Melts down, makes some pimp gloves and boots, and he just gives him like super jumping and
kicking and punching
powers.
Yeah. It was just so ridiculous. It was ridiculous fun. It was a good movie. I'd watch it again.
Oh, I'd absolutely. Greatest. When we say it's the greatest. Montage in cinematic history. We really mean it.
It was
the most entertaining.
It's so funny.
I love how like his hands are like completely clean, and then like he walks down, they're like just covered in blood from hitting rocks. Like it's like his hands like while he's judo chopping, no blood. He walks down, just like it's running off of him.
You know, could I
the rock's blood?
could I say we talked that there's or we you said that there was Star Wars, a lot of Star Wars footage from the space stuff.
A lot.
What about the music?
Oh, yeah, the
Indiana Jones theme song is the theme song to this movie. And there's song from Planet of the Apes. I think there's some songs from the Star Wars movie.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff in there that's just...
Isn't there like, the sad song?
Yeah, that part was in there. Yeah,
that's exactly how it goes there.
It is. Stop laughing at me.
I thought it was... Because the bad thing happened. So yeah, can we all agree it was a really good movie?
It was really entertaining.
It's really entertaining.
Yeah, it's entertaining. It's not a good movie.
Like
but
quality
it's so
wise,
it's
not
funny.
Good, but it's pretty funny.
I think we can all agree that it's not a good movie, but it's corny enough to be hilarious.
Yeah, like it was.
I'd watch it again.
Yeah. And what was
about
the monsters? Right? Like the monsters were like. They look like they were from other TV shows.
Yeah. They're like crappy like kids' shows that they made scarier.
And the and the one part where they're walking through the desert and the guy in the monster mask keeps coming up.
Yeah.
And
it's like
different
that has
masks.
Nothing to do with the show.
It's different masks, but it's the same guy because he's still wearing the same shirt. So it's like they just shot that guy behind the rock. Okay, put this mask on. Alright.
But it, right, has nothing, but it has nothing to do with the story. It's just like...
They just pop up, and then they never, like, show up again. Ever.
Yeah, no. I think it's
five fat skeleton dudes, even though they tear... They make them into 15 people, because they just keep tearing people up with horses.
Oh, yeah, like, no, there's more than 15 people. Like, there's this part, yeah, these skeletons on horses are, like, chasing them. Because, like, eventually, like, they killed an army. Yeah, eventually they killed an army of skeletons. Like, there's only, like, 10 bodies, but, like, it's a montage of just, like, multiple skeletons.
He jumps up on the horse.
Yeah, he jumps on the back of the horse. And that's how you kill a skeleton.
Just put the scene on there.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm gonna. There's a. You can watch the video right just here. Cause
well, should we reenact the scene?
Probably not.
Let's reenact it.
Somebody's gonna get hurt.
I mean, if we had the man who saved the world is here, then somebody get hurt.
What?
Somebody get killed.
Yeah.
Should we maybe talk a little bit about the sequel? I know you two left, and
oh God. Okay, I have seen it.
And Scotty's.
Much higher production value, much less entertaining.
Yeah, oh my god. Nick and I left because of
Except for the guy who made it. I guess we missed the best.
Nick and I suffered through probably, what, an hour of this game?
Yes,
and then, like.
Thank you.
And then, like, we got to the end, and I guess it was funny. And, like, I'm really disappointed.
The end was pretty entertaining. It was just so yes. There's like a lightsaber fight and stuff.
Also, they increased the sex a lot in that movie.
Yeah.
Much more attractive woman.
And that one guy was dancing with the other, like, dude belly dancer.
I don't know what that
oh my gosh.
So that, however, was not sexy.
That was so weird.
I was kind of getting weird.
Like,
I think that's about the time we left.
No, you guys left way before.
Yeah, you left way before. Yeah,
no, because then he was at the castle and he was trying to talk to the daughter and the belly dancer guy was there too. Remember?
Yeah. I don't know when he left. Exactly. I don't know.
Yeah, we did.
I guess that wasn't that late.
Yeah, that was. Because
that was
late.
Before the wedding.
Yeah, that was before the wedding. True. Yeah.
I mean, come on. Anyway, the part where he made it rain, best scene of the movie.
Oh gosh. So okay, explain this to our adoring fans.
Okay, so they're having this party for the wedding, right? And all of a sudden, this guy from like the International Council of Space—I don't know what he was—he just walks in. There's this woman belly dancing to a band. He gets like some paper from his assistant, walks by, and just throws it in the air and makes it rain, and then just keeps walking. It's just this 2 second of perfect, just hilariousness that has nothing to do with anything.
It's a pimp thing.
By the way, space air is great for you.
Yeah, space air. Apparently, space it exists.
It's high quality.
He just needed some space air.
Oh. Well, hey, bring me a chip on the way back.
Hey, why don't you walk right in front of the camera, Nick?
It's the only way.
Alright. Well,
that's about it.
I think we're done with this one. But
yeah,
enough
it's pretty good. Check it out. Got a lot. Get your friends together.
This episode is like the Turkish Star Wars movie. Right. Man Who Saved the World, or Earth.
The Man Who Saved the Earth.
I thought it was called.
No, it's Earth.
Is it Earth?
It's Earth.
Okay.
If you have a poster out there, Scotty and I really want one.
Yeah, they will probably
Man Who Saved the Earth, Turkish film, we need posters.
I've been looking very hard.
Yeah. Side note, I'd buy a $20 poster frame to put your poster on.
Well, yeah, but it's great quality for a great poster.
Happy birthday,
poster.
I can't even have
it. I was going to get you the frame, too. I don't even think...
Made of money? I know, I don't know.
You think I'm freaking just throwing, making it rain all
day? Walking in front of
That's all John Hapley does, making it rain.
Yeah.
Makes it hail. We're too poor for rain.
There's no change.
Just throw pills.
Wow, I think that's...
I'm not
the
host, so
I know.
I'm ready for you.
I know you're trying to host it, though. Listen to that. Well, I think that's about it. I think we'll wrap it up.
Okay!
Alright, guys. Well, we are Ready, Set, Reviews, and that was our review of Turkish Star Wars, a.k.a. The Man Who Saved the Earth, and we hope you guys enjoy, and have a good one.
Tune in next week, where I do the montage from The Man Who Saved the World. Earth.
Earth World.
Earth World.
Eric's just trying to stop the camera now.
Nope.
Maybe.
Maybe it's the